Shalom to the whole house of Yahuah and to all the strangers and foreigners who we find within our gates. I just wanted to come for a quick minute and offer up words of encouragement and endearment, because I know that many people may be facing difficult times, might be in a rough patch of life. But I want to say that in my own experiences, Yahuah has never left me or has never forsaken me. In the things that we ask of Yahuah, there's also things that he asks of us. I asked Yahuah to take away my having. Yahuah said no. It's not for him to take away our habits, be they bad, but it's for us to give them up. A lot of us may have bad habits, but when you want to be a better person, you give up those bad habits and you turn over a new leaf. Of course, as it goes, when you know better, you do better. Amen. I asked Yahuah to grant me patience. Yahuah said no. Patience is a byproduct of tribulations. It isn't granted, it's learned. So even though you might be going through some difficult times, even though things may not be going the way that you want to go, have patience. For everything works for the good of those who love Yahuah. I asked Yahuah to give me happiness. Yahuah said, no. I give you blessings, he says, and barakah. Happiness is up to you. See, Yahuah will grant us these blessings, grant us favor so that we may achieve certain things. And at the same time, many people go all over the world searching for something that's been right in front of their face the whole time. So I would say, in its simplicity, see what's right in front of your face. Enjoy what he has allowed you to acquire. Be content in the little things. I asked Yahuah to spare me pain. Yahuah said, no. Pain or suffering draws you apart from worldly cares and draws you closer to him. Remember, pain will make you remember what not to do. But at the same time, even in a reprimand from Yahuah, think of it as an act of passion, because when he chastises us, he deals with us as he would a son or a daughter. But if he didn't love us, he would leave us lumped in with everybody else to fall to destruction. So I say, count it all joy that when the fiery trial comes upon you, that it is Yahuah who is preparing you. I asked Yahuah to make my spirit, my ruach, grow. Yahuah said, no. You must grow on your own, he said, but he will prune you to make you fruitful. So, when we grow, we establish that there are some things that belong in our lives, and there are some things that has an expiration date. When I was a child, I spoke as a child, I learned as a child, I responded as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. I asked Yahuah for all things that I might enjoy life. Yahuah said, no, I give you life that you may enjoy all things. I asked Yahuah, finally, that's the last one. I asked Yahuah to help me to love others as he loves me. And Yahuah said, ah, now you get the idea. Scripture tells us that the two greatest commandments are, you shall love Yahuah with all of your soul, all of your mind, all of your being. And the second great command is that you shall love others as you love yourself. When we find ourselves entrapped in the decay of vengeance, of unforgivingness, we are slowing ourselves down. So I say here and now, choose love. Choose to self-inventory and see what it is that's holding you back. Because there are things that we ask Yahuah for, but there's things that he asks us for in order that we may be fruitful, as he says. I want to leave with you some scriptures that has illuminated my path unto Yahuah, or that Yahuah used to illuminate my path. The first one is Yeshayahu, Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19, where he says, "If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land, but if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured with the sword, for the mouth of Yahuah has spoken." So right then and there, there's a choice. You can choose to do the things that Yahuah loves, or you can choose to do your own thing. Either way, there is no man walking this earth today or ever has there been who can war with Yahuah and win. The second is Yahuchanan, John chapter 14, verses 13 through 14. "And whosoever shall ask in my name," this is Yahusha speaking, "that will I do, that the Father may be esteemed in the Son. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it." So we can come to the conclusion that Yahuah is delighted in Yahusha, and Yahusha compliments Yahuah. So when you are willing and when you are obedient, the things that Yahuah shall allow you to obtain, the peace is just immeasurable. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 9, "But as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man, the things which Yahuah hath prepared for them that love him." So when you take upon the full armor of Yahuah, when you keep his commands, when you love him diligently to seek his face, he shall bring you into that prepared place. And as it says in Shamu's Exodus, "He shall be an enemy unto thy enemies and an adversary unto your adversaries. You shall abide in the shadow of the Almighty Yahuwah. And whatever pestilence, whatever plague, whatever disruption, whatever evil shall not come nigh to your dwelling place." Amen. And the last one I want to reference is Malachi chapter 3. Verse 10, where Yahuah states, "Bring you all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now herewith, says Yahuah of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of the Shamayim of heaven and pour out a blessing upon you, that there shall not be room to receive it." Oh, somebody need to help me up in here. When we love Yahuah and do the things that are right in his eyes, all of the blessings that shall fall upon us, as it states in Deuteronomy chapter 28 verses 1 through 14, shall come upon you and overtake you. So again, I want to offer up encouragement. I want to offer up esteem. I want to offer up love. Anaya, Auhav, Authak. Yahudia Hebrew language means "I love you." If no one has told you today, know that I do. I love you. You're not going through this alone. You'll never be alone. For Yahuah is always there and will always be there. Okay? Your pain, he is going to use it to turn it into something beautiful. As he says in his scripture, beauty for ashes. So it doesn't matter what happened to you. It doesn't matter who lied on you. It doesn't matter who left you. It doesn't matter. What matters is focus on Yahuah. Focus and pray diligently to seek his face in the name of Yahusha. And his word shall be a light unto your path. I pray here and now that for all of those who have ear to hear and eye to see, that it reach those and it offer up encouragement, inspiration, and fuel their fire for the journey. In the mighty name, Basham, Yahusha, I pray. May Yahuah grant favor and blessings to the readers, hearers, and doers of His word.